Since we have already discussed about the concept in which we have done two tables, the join between the two tables, database table with two tables. We'll be doing the three tables one a bit quickly because we already know the process. So all that we have to understand is the same process with the three tables now. So let's do it now. So I'm taking VBAK table. A VBAK table is for sales order header data. Then we have VBAP table. This is a sales order item data table, VBAP, and then we have something called a MARA table. So MARA will be sales order material data. So these are the three tables that we have. So we are going to go ahead with the join between the three tables, and we are going to create a view for this. So for that we are going to go into SE11, VBAK. Okay, we already seen that. So DXC sales 3. Because it's for three tables, so I'll go for ZDXC underscore sales 3, create. I'm doing exactly the same as we have done previously, but only thing is we are taking the three tables, sales data. And here we'll go for VBAK, VBAP, and MARA. VBAK, VBLN equal to VBAP, VBLN. VBAP MATNR, MARA MATNR. These are the common fields.
So for MARA, the field name is changed.
Yes, exactly. So for MARA, the common field between the VBAP and MARA is MATNR. So that's the common field actually. Based on this common fields, we are going to go for this view fields, and in the view fields, if you select the table fields, we'll get the list of all the table fields. So I'm selecting a couple of fields from VBAK table and a couple of fields from VBAP table. And a few more fields from MARA table. So once it's been done, activate it. So once it's been active, you can go ahead and use this in the program. So let's first see the output. So we are getting the records from all the three tables now. So we'll go ahead and create a program over this. So for this we can use the select star same way as we have done previously. So we'll go ahead and create a program on this sales data 3. So this is the So we are giving select option. We can also give a parameter also for this. So we'll go ahead with the select star from this table into table it underscore say where vbln in s underscore vbln loop at it underscore sl into w underscore sl and loop write so these are the fields that we have. So we have W underscore SEL hyphen VBLN. Okay, save. We can click on this pretty printer actually. Pretty printer will actually correct it to various things. I'll explain you about the pretty printer about the pretty printer later. So we have all these fields. Okay, now we have this. Okay, activate. All these fields and we're doing it a bit quickly because we already have done it with two tables slowly. So these are the fields that we have. And on the other day I was discussing about how to get the heading for this also. So let us go and quickly create a transaction code for this in SE93. So what I'll do is like we'll have this zdxt, so dxc3 create, and then we have sales data. We'll go for selection option. So next program name, we need to give the program name here. So once it's been saved, you can go ahead and check that DXC3. So DXC3 is the transaction code now. So let's go ahead and create ZDXC3. DXC3. So you'll get this value. So 1000 and 100 and 9000. Execute, and we'll get this records here. So. And as I was discussing on other day, variant, if you create it as a variant var one, so automatically it will be filled up, like some values will be filled up. Variant one. Okay, just save it. And now it's been saved here. Now when you come back to this transaction code, if you just open ZDXC3 and you know, go for this variants, you know, update this variant and execute this, automatically all those values will come here. Now let's go ahead with the projection view. What exactly is a projection view and how it will be used is what we'll just discuss about the projection view. So projection view, what exactly is a projection view is what we'll discuss. Projection view is something which is a subset of an existing table. For example, let's say you have say Mara table and you have a lot of records in it. Okay, and you want only 4 or 5 fields or some 10 fields or something like that. So this 10 fields can be extracted from Mara table, and we can create a subset of it. Like this is a small table. So we are creating a small table from a big table. So, and the small table is all virtual table. Okay. So any view is a virtual table, right? So this is a virtual table, which is a small table of the huge table, which we have a lot of records. So we can create a projection view. Projection view has the same properties, like, you know, it cannot store the data and all these things. But in projection view, you cannot add multiple tables. You can have only single table in projection view. That's the main thing here. Okay, so let's go ahead and create a projection view now. Okay, so let's create a projection view on a table which has a huge number of records. So Mara has around 303 fields. Mara table has around 303 fields, but we want only 5-6 fields. Okay. So later I'll explain you why few fields are coming in black, few fields are coming in blue. Those things I'll explain you that. But right now we want to get only 10 fields, just 10 fields. So then what we'll do, we'll create a projection view on Mara. So we'll go for ZPR underscore Mara. Set projection view underscore Mara. So projection view, say next. Material data. So here we have Mara. Table fields. We have MITNR, ERSDA, ERNAM, LAEDA, ANAM, and material MTERT, MATKL. PSTAT. Okay, so we have this. I don't think we have data for this. PSTAT. Okay, so we have a couple of records. Just say okay, and these are all the record. These are the fields that we are getting in the view. That's it. It's been created now. So we just selected it. So all that we have done is we don't have any multiple screens here. We just have a single screen in which we are giving the table name here itself. In the database view, we had two screens which we have used. So first we gave the join conditions, and then we gave the field names. But here we are giving the base table here itself, and then we are getting these things. So just activate it. That's it. So we'll go ahead with the display of data. So this is the data that we have. This is the data that we have. So this is the data that we have. So once we have this again, this projection view acts like a database table, and this database table can be used for this can be used as a database table. So this database table, we'll be creating another program on this. Okay, this is material data. So here we have to go for this tables. We can consider this projection view as a table. So ZDX, CDX, ZDX, sales 3. So we go for data. IT underscore sale types and a table of W underscore sale type ZXC. ZDX underscore sales 3. Now here we'll go for select options. S underscore MATNR for hyphen MATNR. Just as we discussed, you know, we're just copying the properties. So the length and data type is what we'll copy. That's for that reason we are mentioning the fur. Okay, so select star from this this view into table ID underscore. Oh, MAT. Sorry, I'll change this as MAT because this is material data, right? But I created there as you know, a sale tree only a view, so I'll keep it like that only. Okay. Where condition, so where MATNR in S underscore MATNR. Then we'll write the loop at IT underscore MAT into W underscore MAT. And look, so here we'll go for write statement MAT hyphen MATNR. No, I guess I should have taken ZPR underscore Mara, sorry. So let's change that into ZPR underscore Mara, and we'll take all these fields from here. MTRT. Okay. Fine. So I'll take this as ZPR underscore M. So I need to change this as ZPR underscore MA. ZPR underscore Mara. Here also ZPR underscore Mara. Yeah, I think we are good with that. W underscore MAT hyphen.
Sir, in select of statements also sales three is this.
Yeah, I need to change that. Yes, I need to change this to ZPR underscore Mara. Right, ZPR underscore Mara. So here we are creating a subset of a table. So for subset of a table, we are using projection view. Okay, let me take out this data because I think we have a lot of records, but not for this statement, not for that values. Okay, so we have this data in the material. So material data is what we have here. Okay, so we'll go ahead with this. This is a program on production view, and we can also create a transaction code for this. Let's create a transaction code. So we'll copy this program name, go to SE93, and give this as DX4, create decode for material projection data. Oh, I think we have to. Okay, so here I just have to change that to the other option. Screen number 1000. Let's see if it works. Because I had to select the second option there. So let's see. ZDX4. Yeah, it's opening. So here we have this something like, if you want to give some values, you can give it and execute it. So this is a ZDX4 transaction code. Okay, now let's go ahead with the other concept. Once you are clear with this, we'll go ahead with the inner join concept in the next session.